Okay, put your fingers together. Right, higher, higher, like this. No, like this. Okay, wait a minute. Put your thumbs up higher. Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah, yeah. All right. Now, close your eyes. Okay, concentrate. All right, and open. Open your mind to the universe. You feel anything?
Nothing at all.
Okay, well, no, wait a minute, wait a minute. Concentrate, concentrate.
Okay.
Helen, what is it? What is it?
Sorry, Joanna. I can't help it. Maybe it only works for Texans.
It says right here that it works for all human beings. It's universal. All right? Look. We're gonna try it again, okay? All right, get yourself into position. Come on. Into position. That's it. All right, shoulders. Align shoulders up with your hips. Okay, now, right, fingers together. Okay. Close your eyes. Shoulders up. Okay, close your eyes.
To applaud, a star is born. And that star is me.
Thanks a lot, Kathy. Thanks a lot. Just when Helen was getting it.
Getting what?
Getting what? Getting to a higher plane, of course.
Oh, really, Helen? I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. I had a ways to go.
No, you were here. I could see it on your face.
I could.
Don't worry about it. We'll try it later.
Anyway, so what's your big news?
Oh, girls, you won't believe it. How it happened was like in a movie or a fairy tale or something.
Well, go on, tell us.
Oh, I still can't believe it. Okay, I went down to the Gap to get a couple things.
You mean you just bought the entire store?
Well, everything was on sale. And I'd be an idiot not to take advantage of it.
Mm-hmm. Where was I?
Yeah, well, you just bought half the Gap, then...
I'm walking down the street, and this guy literally jumps on me.
Was he cute?
Don't be serious. Just tall, dark, and handsome.
Ooh, this sounds like it's going to be good.
Wait, he says.
Yeah?
Miss, I've been following you for 2 hours.
Oh, another guy with nothing better to do.
Wait, Joanna, let Kathy speak. Okay, so what happened next?
Get this. This guy is a big photographer. And he says, I'm just the girl for this big advertising campaign for this famous perfume.
Get out of here.
Isn't that great?
Just like you said, it's from the movies.
Yeah, but not fairy tales. Because in fairy tales, there aren't any photographers, or any ad campaigns, or any famous perfumes.
Mm-hmm. So, when's the shoot?
Well, it's not that simple. You see, first, I gotta get some test pictures. And then, he's gotta take them to the client. And then, if the client likes them, welcome everybody to the good life. That stuff pays a fortune.
Yeah, well, you'll be living the good life.
No, all of us. I mean, if I had a stroke of good luck like this, it'd be horrible of me not to share it with my girlfriends.
Oh, no, you don't have to do that. Hey, you're the one that's doing the photos.
Shut up. If I say that's the way it's gonna be, that's the way it's gonna be. When I'm a famous top model, I'll need at least two managers.
Oh, Kathy, you're too much.
But there is one problem. I wonder how David's gonna deal with this.
Don't worry about that, Kathy. Your two managers will take care of everything. Huh?
Yes, my friends. I've got to say, I think we've got a hit.
You're right. It sounds good. Let's do the bridge again. Somewhere the bridge doesn't sound right.
The bridge? The bridge was perfect. Don't change a note. No way. I know. We got a hit. All we got to do now is run down to Studio to cut a demo.
Yeah, maybe you're right. But for now, how are we going to do that?
I don't know, but we could play for the girls in the meantime.
Yeah, maybe that would give us some good ideas.
Hey, guys. Remember what we've all decided? Music and girls are two different things. Let's not mix them, okay?
Okay. It was only a suggestion.
Anyhow, someone's gonna hear our music sooner or later.
Sure, but that person is gonna be a bigwig record producer, not three girls that don't know the first thing about music.
Oh, sure. Everybody knows the bigwig record producers are standing in line waiting to buy records.
Listen, Nicholas, I know love has made you blind, but neither Kathy, Helen, or Joanna will help us in what we should know.
Hi, guys. Hope you're not interrupting anything.
Didn't hear any music, so we thought we could come in.
Don't try to hide.
Come and give you Joanna a big kiss. Come on.
And to what do we owe the honor of this visit?
Well, we were in the neighborhood, and we thought it'd be such a nice idea if we came down and said hello.
Wow, how nice.
Aren't you glad to see us?
Well, sure. It was kind of dark in here before, but now that you're here, it's like a ray of sunshine.
Oh, huh. Hey, that's a good one. Maybe we can work that down in a song. Mind if I jot it down?
Don't you move. My little sugar honeybee, I've got everything you need right here in my bag.
Let's see. Paper, pen. Need anything else?
Yeah. Turn around. Oh. Hey, that's great. After all, girls can come in handy sometimes.
Oh, he's so macho. I just love it.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, look. We decided to buy you all a little present. This one's for you, Nick.
Wow, thanks.
And I've got one for you as well.
Wow. Great. Wow, check it out. Where'd you get it?
State secret. I have my sources.
Yeah.
I've got the same sources as Helen.
This deserves a big kiss.
Why are you all looking like this to me? Just because Joanna didn't have time to get a present for me? No big deal. Don't worry, Joanna.
Why, honey, how do you think that I could forget you? My little sugar honeybee. I have a present for you.
Wait a minute. But me, you have to pay in advance, huh? Because if you don't like it.
Nope.
Oh.
Yeah, you can look now.
Got a present.
You know, I thought about it for a really long time, and I thought to myself,
What is he like the best in the whole world?
Was it good?
Yeah, sure. Great shirt.
Well, why don't you go on a little sugar honeybee and put it on right away like we did?
No way.
Sure, okay. Come on, I'll help you. Take the other one off.
Hey, wait up. Don't tear off my head.
Hey, what's to do with the presents anyways? It's not Christmas.
No, but we have some great news.
Actually, maybe we could get into that later. Why don't we all go down to have something to drink at Charlie's, huh?
Don't forget your coat.
Okay. Sounds good.
I think they're up with something.
Well, girls, we're on our third drink here. What's the great news?
Hey, wait. We're not in a hurry, are we? Want something else to drink?
Listen, girls. I gotta tell, we're just drinking orange juice here. So, if you're counting on getting us drunk.
Okay, you drunk. I just want you to feel good, that's all.
Well, if you want to know how to really make us feel good.
Of course.
There's a much cheaper and simpler way to do that.
I feel good already, actually.
Yeah, you could feel better.
Well, now that we all feel better, why don't you guys tell us your big news?
Okay. Well, you have to understand, you know, it's this crazy lucky break.
Yeah, it's such a lucky break. It's like you only get it once in a lifetime.
So what's this great once in a lifetime break?
Well, it's... Go on, Joanna.
Okay. All right, okay. All right, what it is, it's really a marvel. It's incredible. It's really amazing. Amazing. Okay, what happened is, it's crazy, isn't it crazy? It's just, it's fantastic. It's really divine. It's just, it's really
stupid. Stop. Are you gonna run through the whole entire list of superlatives? Just go right to the point.
Come on, you've got us on the edge of our seats. So what's the big news?
Okay. I'll tell you. I ran into this photographer who wants me to star in his next campaign.
Like you and the ads and the magazines and stuff like that?
Yes, her. Hey, what's so crazy about that?
Hey, wait up, girls. You're the one who's been saying that this is crazy for the last hour. We didn't say anything.
Yeah, but you guys obviously don't realize. I mean, this is really great. This is such a great chance. I mean, Kathy could become like this huge, humongous, international super-duper star. Like.
David, what's wrong? Don't you like the idea?
No, it's not that. I'm just surprised. Aren't you surprised, Nicholas?
Sounds like a personal problem.
What? What is the problem? I mean, is she so ugly that a photographer would never take her for a campaign?
Of course not. Kathy's beautiful. Anyone with eyes in her head can see that. That's not what I meant at all.
What exactly did you mean?
I meant that you're my Kathy, and I'm just gonna have to get used to the idea that you're gonna be everyone else's Kathy if you do those ads.
It could have been a lot worse, you know.
Sure. Did you see the look on David's face when he said, everybody else is Kathy?
He didn't mean it. Not in a bad way.
If I do these photos, he's never gonna forgive me.
Yeah, well, if you don't do them, you're crazy. Kathy, look, don't you realize that this is an opportunity? Maybe one day a TV producer will see you, or even a movie director. Come on, lots of stars get started that way.
I don't want to be a star. I just want to finish college and live happily ever after with David.
Listen, Kathy, you can do it all. And in any case, you can't give in to David, just on principle. It's your pictures, your face, and your body. Don't let David, you know, tell you what to do.
So what? You're a hardcore feminist now?
I'm not a hardcore feminist now, but I really believe it.
Come on, Kathy, Helen's right. You can't let yourself be blinded by love like that. You can't pass this up.
Even if that means losing David.
Why do you have to lose David? You don't have to.
Kathy, were you planning to, you know, like spend the night with a photographer?
Spend the night? Oh, what?
What does one usually do at night with a guy?
Me? No way.
So where's the problem? Come on. David had, he can't say anything.
It would still be better if he approved.
Don't worry, he will, because we're going to take care of it.
Still reading those magazines, David? Stop it, you make yourself sick.
Leave him alone, he can do what he wants.
Don't worry about it, Nicholas, it's all right. You know, Chris, tell you the truth, it's kind of weird to think that one day it'll be my Kathy in these magazines instead of one of these other girls.
You mean you're gonna let her do it?
Of course, it's her problem. I don't own Kathy.
What do you mean you don't own Kathy? She's your girlfriend.
Just because she's my girlfriend doesn't give me the right to tell her what she can and can't do.
You mean you're just gonna let her pose half naked in one of those mags?
What do you mean half naked? It's a perfume ad.
Whatever it is. Perfume, detergent, cream cheese, they're all half naked. Check it for yourself.
Chris, stay out of this. Mind your own business.
Okay, I'll shut up.
What? Little honeybee's gonna go and pout now?
Oh, Patty, you can't say anything in this place.
Look, you just shouldn't tell David what he ought to do, that's all. He's old enough to decide for himself.
Yeah, what if Ellen pulls naked for an underwear ad or something?
First of all, that would never happen. But if it did, she would have to decide.
That's really funny. You guys are so cool. If Joanna ever did that to me, I wouldn't think twice of what I'd do to her.
Well, Chris, what would you do?
She had to choose. The photos or me.
Poor Joanna. What an awful choice between fame and her little sugar honeybee.
Yeah, keep on laughing. On top of it all, you don't know how corrupt this business is. All the photographers are sex maniacs. And if the girls want to get ahead, they'll have to submit to their whims.
Maybe some girls, but not my Kathy. I trust her completely.
Yeah, we'll see. Hope you don't regret this.
It's really great you guys came with me.
It's not great. It's completely normal, Kathy. We are your managers.
And don't you worry. We're going to take care of this photographer.
I hope you won't be too surprised to see three of us show up.
If he's coming here to go over details like your hair, your makeup, your wardrobe, flights, dates, prices, I think we should be here to write everything down.
Yeah. And if he ever tries to hit on you, well, don't worry. He has to do with us first.
There he is. That's him. Hey, Patrick.
Hey. I'm sorry. Hope I'm not too late. I was just waiting on some lab prints.
No, no, it's okay. Here, yeah. Grab a chair.
Okay.
Let me introduce you to my friends. This is Joanna, and this is Helen.
Above all, we're her managers.
Yeah, we work with her.
For her.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well, looks like I fell into a whole den of pretty ladies. Any more like you back home?
No, we're the only ones.
Well, I'd have to get your home address.
So, tell us what you want.
That's great. You shouldn't waste any time.
Well, you know, time is money, isn't it? Yeah. And, Kathy, you should have told me he was so gorgeous.
Yeah. said to the other paper, I said, if you don't like my pictures, then you can just take them. So.
No, you didn't dare.
In any case, I didn't have much of a choice, you know. The studio was already taken.
Also, listen, Patrick, let's just go over everything, okay?
All right.
All right, so Kathy needs to be at the studio tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. She should take two summer outfits with her. Mm-hmm. There will be a hairdresser, but she should take her makeup in case she doesn't like what the makeup artist does.
And you're a real computer.
Only when she wants to be. Anyway, when will we get the client's answer?
Well, I'll have the photos tomorrow night, and then I'll have the prints the day after tomorrow, mm-hmm. and then we can present them to the clients that afternoon.
And when will we have the answer?
Right away, you know? Don't worry about it. They'd have to be crazy not to like you. You know, you're really very pretty.
Do you really think so?
No, no. Absolutely not. You must be one of the most hideous girls on the face of the earth.
You really are pretty. Do you have a boyfriend?
Time out. Time out. Patrick, yes, she does have a boyfriend. His name is David, and he's very handsome, he's very big, and they're very much in love, all right?
That's too bad. Oh, well, it's my tough luck. Anyways, work comes first, and I really think we have a 90% chance that this is gonna work.
Well, if it does work, then what happens?
Then we're gonna go to the Bahamas next weekend.
The Bahamas?
The light is much better there.
Oh, wow. And how long do you have to stay there?
Well, we're gonna stay about a week. You know, we got 2 days to get over the jet lag, and then 2 days to get a tan, and then click, click, it's work time. And then we're gonna see if everything looks good, you know, and then we either come back right away or we can stay for 3 days just to relax.
Do I really have to go there?
Well, yeah, you know, the whole idea of the ad campaign was based on freshness.
Kathy, the Bahamas are great. You're gonna love them. I was there with my folks when I was a kid. It's incredible. It's like a paradise.
But I've got classes.
Oh, look, don't worry. You know, the finals are a long time away, and we'll give you our notes. And there's...
Wow, David, listen. This is great news. You know where Kathy's gonna do her pictures with Patrick? The Bahamas.
I'm telling you, if you let her go, you're crazy.
Chris, can't very well forbid her to go.
Did you see how the photographer was looking at her? I'm sure he's in love with her.
I'm afraid of that, too. Nicholas, what do you think?
I really don't know what to tell you, David.
What would you do if you were me?
Tell him, Nicholas. What if Helen was going to the Bahamas with that guy?
I wouldn't be very happy about it. That Patrick guy seems like a real pickup artist.
A pickup artist? The guy's a professional seducer. Any girl on vacation in the Bahamas with a guy like that will have to give in.
Wait a minute. They're not going on vacation. They're going to work.
Yeah, sure. Work. Did you hear their plans? 2 days of Betty Bye. 2 days of Tanorama. And probably half an hour of picture taking or something.
Come on. Kathy's not going to give in to the first guy that comes along.
You don't know anything about girls. The Bahamas sunshine. Long evenings. Only 1 out of 1,000 could resist. Not mentioning that Patrick guy isn't bad looking.
Chris, stop. You're gonna make him sick.
Better get him sick now rather than hopeless later.
Hi, guys.
Kathy, what are you doing here?
David, we need to talk.
Okay, we'll get out of here. You coming, Chris?
Yeah, I'm coming. Dave, remember what I told you, man.
Kathy, we gotta...
No! David, let me speak. I've decided not to do the photos.
Oh, Kathy.
The only thing I ask of you is if you can come with me to tell Patrick. I don't know if I can do it on my own.
Oh.
Look, I'm sorry, but I think Kathy was really wrong. I really think that was a chance of her life.
Shut up, Joanna. You're talking nonsense. It's the greatest proof of love that Kathy could have given to David. I think it's wonderful.
Well, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, but if you're counting on me to give you a proof of my love like that, you can just forget it.
Oh, yeah, like I'll have to worry about that. Nobody will ever ask you to star in an ad. Probably for a brand of cold cuts or something.
Cold cuts? Cold cuts?
Look at your love boots. Stop it.
Well, leave them alone. It's just beginning to get interesting. I was wondering if the blood would hit us all the way over here.
Blood? I don't think I'd actually draw blood, you know. I mean, I love him too much for that.
Lay off. Lay off. I'm fragile.
That's why I like you so much.
Oh, look. Here come the other two lovebirds.
Hi, everybody.
So, how'd it go? Was it tough?
It's terrifying. It took a whole 5 minutes. The ad campaign flopped.
That's funny. It's not very funny for your photographer friend.
Well, first of all, he's not my friend. He's just a nice guy. And secondly, that's not why I'm laughing.
Why are you laughing?
It's David. Tell him, David, I can't go on.
Well, we get to the agency, and we ask to see Patrick. And it turns out that he'd been looking for her all day to tell her that the campaign had been canceled.
So what's the deal?
Wait till you hear this. Go on, David.
Well, just then this guy comes up to me and starts asking me all these questions and tells me he's the art director for the agency and that I'm just the guy he's been looking for.
For a men's underwear campaign.
No way!
That's too much!
What did you tell him?
Well, I said no, of course.
But then I reminded him that you need to pay for some studio time to cut a demo.
Did you say yes?
Well, yeah.
That's great, my darling. I've always wanted to be seen with a sex symbol.
David, you know, if you need a manager, don't forget, Helen and I are out of a job now.